Today, he told us he's hoping that the president of the state's This is the worst time exceptional drought has ever been declared in California. Four communities in 10 counties. Water to run out in 60 days. In Montego, that applies to this recycling every drop. In an arm set of the county, calling on lots of fish out. Now major cities are also feeling the pressure. Most get their water from reservoirs. These before and after pictures show where water levels should be and where they are today. Lakes, watersheds are in serious trouble. Tonight, in communities and in farm fields all across California, they're waiting. But like the current situation, the forecast here looks bleak. Brian, we both have about 50 feet in this reservoir to give you a different perspective. You see just how dry it is here. This should be California's wettest month January. Officials here say we have had less than little or no rainfall. They are saying we may be entering what is called a mega drought, a drought that lasts for years.
Brian, I believe that the situation in California continuing to go on here in Delaware, those kind of happenings. There has been a terrible tragedy in western Kentucky in a small town where a house caught fire during the early morning hours today in the third bowl. Nine members of a single family were killed, a mother and eight of their children. ABC's John Dang is our victim.
The small wood frame house was engulfed in flames when the firefighters arrived shortly after 2 a.m. in contact. 11 people lived in the three-bedroom home. Chad Watson, 36-year-old landowner, his 35-year-old wife, Nick, and their 9 children, oldest, 15, youngest, 4-year-old twins. Amy Chad and a daughter, 11-year-old Kylie, escaped both critically injured. The firefighters alone told the first responders that the whole family is here. Eight of the bodies were found in the front master bedroom, the ninth about 10 feet away. Raiders said the family was well established in a small deadline community. Second generation to live in a house. On the Power Room Manager's Church's Facebook page, we will cover the DNR bugs and cause for the survivors. Investigators said an electric issue event the Periscope Ignited nearby the Muscle Material for a chamber for their teams. According to the National Fire Protection Association, stationary at quarter of space is about for a third of the fire year and 81% of deaths. A heart and yet all too familiar cold weather tragedy. John Hammond, senior Chicago.
Federal prosecutor said today that they received a death penalty for the Boston bombing suspect Joe Marks on Monday after a final acceptance made by the U.S. Attorney General Redmond. So he was accused of planting two bombs within the office of the Federation of Boston. Three people have been paid over 260 others that have been here now and two citizens from the top of the police. Those were the has been set. It's New Orleans tonight for a one-time American exchange student, Amanda Knox, just over 2 years after she was acquitted of an earlier murder conviction in Italy and set free to return to the States. Her jury now says in her second retrial she is guilty of killing her roommate. The video reports tonight from NBC's Keith Miller that several attacks were reported in the years ago. Everyone thought this was going to have to work.
Feel like a traitor. They would order my arrest and they might have
That U.S. Air Force cheating scandal involving nuclear missile launch officers has widened to high officials say 92 officers at Mount Forever Air Force Base in Montana have now been implicated. That's about half the task we've handled. All missile launch operations at that base. Officials say 44 are accused of actually cheating on a proficiency exam while the efforts allegedly hit the target today. And a surprise announcement out of Washington today, a big figure in Democratic politics is Colleen Woods. Henry Waxman has represented his Secretary of Justice to Beverly Hills for 20 terms in Congress. Senator Day won't be seeking re-election. Waxman has been a force on these environment, healthcare issues, especially as one of minority leader Nancy Pelosi's closest allies in the House. His retirement, along with those who joined him,